Hey, my name's Dan. Welcome to my shop. If you're new here, then this is the place you want to be if you are interested in scratch building your own model airplanes or flying model airplanes or, well, like I said, scratch building your own model airplanes, because really, to tell you, it's kind of a lost art, and we're bringing it back. So today, my shop assistant and I are working on the airframe. We're building the fuselage. And the tricky part about the fuselage is, it's not tricky at all. It's actually pretty straightforward and easy. Right now I've got it all mocked up. I haven't put a drop of glue on this yet. I've simply used the magnet board to hold everything in position so that it's going to be exactly where it is when it is time to glue it. But I just want to make sure that everything fits dry before I go ahead and start gluing, because I think that if you don't take the time to make sure that everything fits together and then you actually start gluing stuff together and you find out, oh, I should have sanded that a little bit more, or I should have shortened the length on that a little bit more, it gets harder to play that catch up after you've already gone underway of gluing parts down. So I'm doing that right now, and so far everything looks pretty good. The main thing you want to concentrate while you're building the fuselage is building it squarely and straightly. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start at this end here on the firewall and getting the side situated with it first. And I'm going to use these big old heavy duty bar clamps. I know this is overkill, but the problem is this fuselage is wider than my hobby bar clamps will go. So I had to get out the big boys, but I know they're not going to move. It just to me looks kind of funny to have to use something that big, but it's going to be very effective. Anyways, the procedure I'm going to use on this is I'm going to go ahead and start by gluing and establishing the box that's in the front. This is the part that's actually in contact with the plan at this time. So with it in contact with the plan, and then you can see it starts tapering up toward the back here, and this part is actually off of the paper, is not on there. So I want to get the part square that's firmly to the ground. And then also on the back here, I don't know if you can see this from there, but maybe you could see it from a different shot. I built a crutch that is holding up the back end. Okay, you can't switch chairs. You've got to stay in your chair. I've built a crutch that is holding up the back to the right elevation so that that is squarely down and the rest of it is evenly going to meet together on the other end at F8, which is out here. So, like I was saying, we're going to start with F1, getting it all set up nice and square and level, and work our way and just continue to add more formers as we go down the line, making them permanent with glue as we go. I've got them in there for testing right now, but eventually we'll be go ahead and putting the glue to them and making it a solid box. Now, like I was saying, the key thing is you want to keep things straight. And this is where my magnet system really helps out, because so you can see on here, I've taken and put the magnets right on the line of where that side needs to be sitting, so it can't go outside of that. Wood is not a perfect material. Just because you're using a straight piece or a sheet of wood does not mean that it's going to be straight. It's going to have some kind of wow and curvature to it. And I've also found that when I put the doublers on here with the glue, the doublers were made of a light ply, which is kind of a little crummy kind of plywood, and it's really affected by things like moisture. So when I put that white or wood glue on there, it went ahead and made the doubler kind of have a little bit of a bow to it. So when I put the bow onto the flat piece of siding, it actually has now made it so the sides are not perfectly flat. So we're going to get that flatness back in this procedure by building this all square. And then when we go to put the sheeting that goes from here, there's going to be some sheeting that goes from here all the way to back to the stabilizer on the top and also on the bottom. That sheeting is going to be key to making it so that the body does end up being straight, because it'll be using the formers on the inside to form up the sides flat from there. And then it will be using the sheeting, which will keep pulling it from the outside to make sure that it all works correctly. And it will make this all square again. But as you're working on this, be looking down the body to make sure that you're not getting what we call banana. in your fuselage. And that's just a curvature that could happen from setting formers incorrectly or something. You want to keep making sure that you've got the tail back here in the right spot and it doesn't move around. So if it starts going one way or another as you're building, you've got to make corrections to make sure that it ends up being straight when everything is done. And then, like I said, when we go to put those sheeting pieces on there, that's going to seal the deal and make it permanent to whatever condition it's in. So be straight at that point. That's what we're trying to do here. Well, that's about it. I'm going to get started on this. I'm going to start with the firewall F1. And today I'm going to use, normally I would use epoxy for that to hold it in place, but today I'm going to use Gorilla Glue. I want that particular joint to be a glue that is strong but also flexible. I don't want to use CA in that particular joint because CA tends to be pretty brittle. And that board, the firewall, is going to have a lot of vibration on it from the engine. So we want to have it in a way so that when it's cold outside or we're flying in conditions where I'm using the engine a lot. I guess every flight you're using the engine a lot, otherwise it wouldn't be on the air. Well, you know, it's technical. But anyways, I just want that firewall piece to have a little bit of flexibility in it so that it's not going to just break off. If you ever have a hard landing and it just kind of bounces the plane and it puts a shock through the plane, the weight of that engine way out on the front can actually snap the firewall off. I've done it before. And so we're going to take some measures to make sure that we strengthen that up with the proper glue, but also some reinforcements that are shown right on your plans, and I'll show them to you when we get to that point. But anyways, I'm going to start with that and just kind of work my way back. And that's the plan for today. We'll see how it goes. Thank you. of at a stopping point for today, but I do want to give you a quick walkthrough on what I did with the fuselage today. Everything is now pretty much glued. I mean, I've got firewall is in. You can see from the Gorilla Glue a little bit of foam there. I will cut that out before I stick the reinforcement triangle in there that's going to go in that spot. Landing gear plate is down on the base. It's going to need a little bit of triangle around it as well. And then all the formers are now in place. So here's F2, F3, and F4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 out on the end. I also today made this little block that goes out here. This is just simply a 1/2 by, what did it end up being? 1 1/4 here by 2 1/16 tall. And then it's a 1/2 inch from front to back. And I just basically shaped that. So now that's ready to go. That's the tail post that the rudder is going to mount onto. And that's all done. One thing I wanted to point out, something that I think might be a necessary upgrade here. This one here, which one is this? This is F4. Okay, now this one here is made of balsa, and so is F5 right here. See these little bars I made? I made just took a quick 1/8 scrap and added a bar that goes across here, and then also one you can see down on the bottom of it too. When I put these formers in just to test fit them, they flexed, and actually this one broke in half, this F4. I had to glue it back together again. The reason why is because the way the grain is on this, it's the grain on this one goes up and down, and it makes this center piece here very flimsy and weak. So by putting one piece that goes this way with the grain going this way, it adds so much more strength to that, so we don't have to worry about that breaking. Did that one to 4 and 5. I might even go back and do 6 and 7 as well. I don't know, I'm thinking about that. It is going to add a little bit of weight, and I just don't want this to break. Now, one thing that will happen is eventually that cap is going to go on the top, and that's going to be a cross grain of balsa that is going to be the sheeting top that's going to go on this part. And so maybe that'll add enough strength. So I don't know, I'm going to reconsider that and see how that works. Got all these triangle stocks put into place on every one of these places that calls for it. And pretty much that's it. But the main part with these magnets and everything is I just like looking down that and going, that is a nice straight fuse. And it's thanks to the magnets holding it very firmly to the board and working very, you know, it made it very easy to make this a straight fuselage. So I think the goal has been met here. And that's pretty much gonna be what I'm gonna finish out for today. So that went pretty well today. I'm pretty happy with how everything has turned out, and everything seems like it's straight and firmly glued down at this point. And that's what we were shooting for. If you have any questions about what I did today, or you know, have any other ideas or other things to go with this, please put a comment in the comment section down below. And if I see it, I'll respond to it, especially if you have a question that you need, you know, something. I know that there's several of you that are out there actually building this plane now, and it's kind of fun to be able to work alongside when other people are doing it too. That way you can say, oh, wow, I tried this and it fixed that, and I might just do that too. I don't know. I just kind of made that up. I don't know if that really makes any sense. But anyways, if you haven't, please do subscribe and ring that bell down below, because we would love to have more subscribers and build a better community for building and scratch building model airplanes. It's something that, you know, it's a lot of fun once you get going in it and you realize that the potential out there of the things you want to build is just endless. So please subscribe and hit that bell, and you'll be notified every time we post a new video. And, you know, my wife kids me and goes, who do you mean by we? And well, we, you know, every time we post a new video. Turns out that Kitty is a master editor. Huh, who knew? So anyways, until next time, keep on building. Okay, well, I think I better go get all the files off the camera and get it put away. What are you gonna getting you to go out there and work out? All right, call it a wrap.